This city is sports mad. Baseball, hockey, basketball, bowling. You name it, they play it, which is probably why Jay Ajayi fits right in. Jay was born in London, where he always seemed to have a football in his hands.
Steps up in the far side.
Fast forward to today, and not much has changed.
He gives it off to Ajayi. Ajayi has a first down or more. Cuts back at the 40, the 50, the 45, down to the 43. Goes the former Miami Dolphin. The Philadelphia Eagles are Super Bowl champions.
He's a superstar in the States. But he was born in Britain to Nigerian parents at a time when it wasn't cool to admit that you had African roots.
What's funny is, you know, my African name for short is Dammy. And I can remember being young in school and instead of calling me Dammy, they'll call me Dummy, you know? So that's kind of something funny that, you know, you can remember as a kid. Yeah, I think it's been a real interesting just revival kind of in the sense of just seeing how the African culture has gone so mainstream in society today. The music that we listen to, the sounds that a lot of these artists are using are African sounds or come from that area. The fashion, the way that we look, you know, people they gravitate towards it, you know. I feel like African people, we have a flair to us, you know, and a sense of pride. And I think that, you know, different cultures see that and, you know, they've started to appreciate, you know, what we do.
Jay's family moved to the US when he was just 7 years old. He credits his success on the field to his Nigerian upbringing.
One of the biggest things for me growing up is the sense of family. When it comes to being Nigerian, you know, family is really important. I think that that's helped me along my careers, my support system, the fact that my family, we can all rely on each other. Another thing is just the grind that Africans have and Nigerians, like seeing my parents hustle, you know, trying to make a better life for myself and my siblings, obviously moving us from the London to the States for my dad's job opportunity that he had at the time, and just kind of seeing how they just work and, you know, that sense of pride of wanting to create something for the generations down. When I play my sport and in my game, you know, I feel like I'm representing my Ajayi name, my family's name, and wanting to leave that legacy, you know, wanting to have something that the future generations and my children will be proud of. And I can definitely credit that to, you know, just how my parents raised us and, you know, just that culture that we have.
Family, friends, football. I thought I'd learn everything about Jay when we met at his place. But there was another side to him that he hadn't shown me yet.
I do have this kind of persona, the alter ego. It's called the Jay Train. That's like my personality on the field, where it's just this super ultra competitive mode. When I'm just in this J train, it's like you don't want to get in that guy's way. My focus is always winning.
I soon learned that with Jay, that means winning at everything at all costs. One minute we were talking, and the next we were bowling. I guess once you've won the Super Bowl, anything with the word bowl in it suddenly becomes worth fighting for. For most people, this is a friendly game, but Jay Ajayi isn't most people.
Killing them, bro. You're going on BBC Africa, bro.
As the strike started to roll in, I knew what was coming next. Losing to Jay, there was a press-up price to pay.
Come on. Thanks for coming out here. You know?
Thanks for coming out, man. Seriously, we enjoyed you.
It was a real pleasure. Showing us the bowl.
We're competitive,
you
man.
Guys. That's clear.
I've known these guys for almost 10 years, man. They're competitive. We want to win. So this is not a game. He's laughing and everything, but he's dead serious.
Competitive to the end. They're still here. You mean like, you know, we're about to leave, but they are still bowling. Jay ain't leaving until Jay leaves. I'm telling you now. So I think it's best if we get out of here. Let Jay do his thing. I think we should leave.